Hello, welcome back to the Castaway Kitchen YouTube channel. I am Christina Kerr, functional nutritional therapy practitioner and new restorative wellness solutions practitioner. So I'm really excited to continue to grow my education, certifications, and this community, and very recently have really expanded on my content about around Hidradenitis Suppurativa. And the reason for that is because that is the autoimmune disease that I have. And well, okay, let me rephrase that. HS is an autoinflammatory condition, but I treat it like an autoimmune disease because I feel like it works and it is in that kind of family. And I feel like HS people are part of the autoimmune community, as many of us also have autoimmune disease as well that comes along with the HS. So very recently, very proud, I launched my holistic HS course and as well as a holistic HS website. So holistichidradenitissuppurativa.com is now owned by me, and it goes into like a WordPress landing page that I have that links all of my HS resources, including my HS course, my survival guide, and my personal story with HS. So Hidradenitis Suppurativa is an autoinflammatory skin condition, and it's not 100%. No one exactly knows. There were over the years, several different schools of thought. I think the old school mentality, when I was a child, I was told it was a sweat gland issue. Then it was, no, it's the hair follicle that gets clogged. And the most recent studies say that it is an over keratinization of the skin, essentially just like too much, you know, an inflammatory response, and the skin just kind of creates these bumps, right? Which as we know, can then get pus filled or open and create wounds. But at the root, we do know that Hidradenitis Suppurativa is an auto-inflammatory condition. It is rooted in inflammation, often swelling in the skin. It affects people under arms, inner thigh, under breasts are the most common places. Some people get it behind their ears or chest or scalp, but it is a condition that can be extremely debilitating because of where it is, of any place where skin folds and rubs, even like on the outsides of like out areas of the genitals and buttocks. Although it is not contagious, it is not an STD, it is not connected, or it is not because of your body size or lack of hygiene. Unfortunately, a lot of doctors are still telling people that they have Hidradenitis Suppurativa because they're overweight. What's interesting is that in my community, which is made up of hundreds of thousands of people, I get so many hundreds and hundreds of comments and testimonials from people who suffer from HS who are very thin and have always been thin. And when you think about that, a lot of people, most people develop HS in their teenage years around puberty. I don't think that HS, the correlation between Hidradenitis Suppurativa and body size, it's not causation, it's correlation. And when you think of how difficult it is to grow up with this painful, embarrassing condition, that's probably what leads people then to seek the serotonin of food and treats and sugar. And then maybe that is the correlation with body size. But again, it's not the cause. And I can tell you that I'm proof of that because I'm someone who, for all intents and purposes, has always been on the bigger side. And when I first got into remission, I lost some weight, but I gained it back during the pandemic and I stayed in remission. So my weight fluctuation wasn't correlated to being in remission. So there's a more anecdotal proof. And I think that's where HS in general, there's a lot of anecdotal information and not enough scientific studies that can make these connections to diet changes, to what actually causes it. But I hope that through my community that we can continue to gather data and prove to the world that we can live amazing, thriving lives, and that Hidradenitis Suppurativa doesn't have to control it. So as we dive into what can help HS, I want to start by saying that I understand that this condition can leave you feeling really hopeless. And when I say that gut health and diet matters and is often at the root of like what makes us flare, that's not me putting blame on you. I didn't feel someone was saying I was to blame that I had this condition because I ate nightshades most of my life. How do you know something? You don't know something until you know something. And this information is not widely available. So I sometimes people get defensive in my comments on social media being like, well, I've tried everything and nothing helps. And I was only, someone said the other day, they were only eating blueberries and peanut butter and they were still flaring. And I, that's not a healthy diet either. That's completely nutrient deficient and that's not going to help you heal your gut or reduce inflammation. Unfortunately, the wider information out there regarding how to heal our gut and how to eat in an inflammatory way is not mainstream knowledge. So you don't know what you don't know until you know it. And it's not in any way, shape or form putting blame on you. I'm one of you. I know I lived with this condition, riddling my body, scarring it permanently since I was 13 years old. And I wasn't till I was 32 that I finally got it under control and like started learning all of this for myself. So one, understanding that the inflammatory responses in our body are mediated or by our immune system. And 70% of our immune cells live in our gut. So when we're saying that what you eat has to do is going to have to do with chronic symptoms and inflammation, we're saying that there are foods that could be part of your diet that may be causing inflammation in your body. And food sensitivity tests may or may not pick up on these because yes, some of them can be food allergies or food sensitivities, but some of it could just be, there could be leaky gut, meaning the lining in your gut is damaged and food's getting through into your bloodstream. Some of it can be because of dysbiosis or gut infections. And then certain foods are feeding these opportunistic pathogens. There are so many different pathways in which diet can contribute to inflammation. Another is blood sugar dysregulation, you know, really processed sugars and starches and grains and stuff like that often lead to blood sugar dysregulation and inflammation. Chronically high insulin is inflammatory. Same thing with other foods like canola oil, where it's not really a food allergy. It's just a like food that causes oxidative stress on the body because it's so bad for you. So when, go into that journey of healing your body, it is kind of like this spectrum of lifestyle / diet changes that need to take place, and they're not going to happen overnight. So that's why in my Holistic HS course, I have one, the pathology of the disease. Two, I have a 3-tiered elimination approach that explains the hows and whys of eliminating specific foods, and also gives you meal plans so you can like put into action right away. Then we have lifestyle, sleep, stress management, movement, all those things, why they're important, how to optimize your digestion, not just with supplementation, but with habits, because you're not going to have, you need all the healthiest food in the world and it's still going to cause gut issues if you're not breaking it down properly. And then of course, there's the supplement support and topical support, things to help balance your hormones, to help your body detox, to help with digestion, to help reduce inflammation, and topical support, because while HS is something that has to be addressed from the inside out, unfortunately, the skin can often be the last organ to get the memo, and using topical support to help us along the way is going to be key. So promise me that you're going to give yourself 6 months. Promise me that you're going to become an investigator and you're going to troubleshoot and you're going to do research and you are going to become the expert in you, because no one lives in your body and no one can tell you what's going to work and what's not. But when you go down this path of holistically treating Hidradenitis suppurativa, you're going to be alone in a lot of ways, because in this tiny little corner of the internet, this is what we do. But when you talk to other people in groups and when you talk to doctors, they're going to think you're crazy and they're going to tell you that there's no correlation. But remember that your body wants you. Your body wants you to thrive. Your body wants you to be healthy. Your body's constantly fighting for homeostasis. And I believe that everyone can achieve that. And so I truly hope that you set your sights high and that you don't give up. It took me over a year to get into remission, over a year of troubleshooting and elimination diets and working on my health and really restructuring my entire life to get here. But it's been worth it because now I live pain-free. And it's every day a constant chugging along of making these choices, the way I live, what I eat, what I drink, when I go to sleep, how I move, everything plays into staying into remission. But my life is overall better because of it in so many ways. So it's hard. It's hard to commit. It's hard to make the changes. It's hard to be the odd man out. It's hard to prioritize yourself so much, but you're worth it. And I don't want you to ever forget that.